All right. So, your first question is, okay, only this part is your question. To save time and to do more applications in limited amount of time, I am doing the solution and then I am explaining it. So, you are given a question like this, okay. So, looks like there is no highlighter in this software as of now. No issues. Okay, so you are given a rod, okay, that blue color rod from A to D, there is a rod, okay. So, that rod is having three different materials. A to B, it is a different material. B to C, it is a different material. C to D, it is a different material, okay. And their lengths are given and their Young's modulus are given. What is the question is, you are supposed to calculate displacement of the junction, okay. So, that is your actual question. Now, to calculate the displacement of junction, okay. So, we are supposed to first calculate extension in each wire, okay. So, for that, what is the logic is, we know that, okay, your tension is the restoring force here, because nowhere mass of the rod is mentioned. So, there is no possibility of having variable tension, okay. Here, there is no variable tension. So, tension is constant, that will be only your restoring force. So, we will use this formula, Young's modulus is equal to force by area, whole divided by change in length by original length. From that, your change in length formula, you will get it. So, now, your first, we will calculate what is the extension in entire wire, okay. Extension in the wire is different, extension at point is different. So, now, we are calculating the extensions in the wire separately. We want extension at a point. Extension at a point is different from extension in wire. So, we have calculated extension in wire AB. This is wire BC. And extension in wire CD is this much. Okay. So, we have calculated extensions in the wires like this. Now, what is asked is, you are asked extensions at particular points. So, exactly at B if you want extension, okay, because the top part is rigid, that means at point A, your point top part is rigid. Rigid in the sense it is not actually moving. So, because it is rigid at this point, okay, here it is rigid. Because it is rigid, okay, your extension at point B is extension because of top wire alone, okay. On the top, there is no extension. So, that is why in the entire extension, whatever it is there, it will be in the bottom part, okay. So, that is your extension of B, okay. Next, your extension at C, if you are taking extension at C is, you will have extension on the top at B, how much is the extension? That much plus extension at C, both will be considered. So, that is why we are doing some. Similarly, extension at D is extension on first wire, second wire as well as third wire, all the three wires. Okay. So, like this, you have to calculate and then give the answer. Okay. So, this is how you are supposed to do it. You simplify, you will get the answers. Okay. 4 into 5, 15. Yeah. You add all these values, you will get the required answers. Okay. Right. Now, next. Try this question. Your second question is question number 2. Your second question is, there is a 2 kg block and there is a 1 kg block like this, okay, and a force of find longitudinal strain in both wires, okay. You have two wires. Question is, find strain in both wires. That is your question. Okay. So, that is your question. What is given is, your area of cross section is 0.1 0.005 centimeter square. Young's modulus is 2×10^11 newton per meter square. Your acceleration due to gravity is g=10 m/s². Okay. Now pause this video and then try the question. Okay. Then I will explain the answer. Okay. So both are metal wires. Nothing is mentioned about the mass, but you are given area of cross section. Okay. Try the question. I will explain the solution. Okay. Hope you have tried for sufficient amount of time. So your answer is, first on this, if mg is acting, obviously you will have 10 N. On this wire you will have tension T1, here it is T1, here it is some T2. So if you are taking FBD of 1 kg, on 1 kg you have T1 to the top, mg=10 downwards, so that is why you are going to get T1=10. Second, 2 kg, this is 1 kg, so on this it is T2, on this it is T1. Okay, so your T is 2g, so T2 is equal to 2g plus T1, that is equal to 20 plus 10, so finally you are going to get 30 N. So you have got tension T1 and T2. Now to get the strain, you are given Young's modulus also in the question. So your Young's modulus is given as 2×10^11 newton per meter square. This I must have given in the question. It is my mistake, no issues. Mistakes do happen. So what is your question is, you are supposed to calculate strain. So Young's modulus is stress by strain. Stress is force by area. Strain you are in the denominator, you keep area of cross section, you have to keep it in meter square. So 1 cm² is 10^-4 meter square. So you substitute that. So your strain on top wire is strain 1. This is 1, this is 2. If you assume your strain 1 is, sorry, this is 2 you assume, this is 1 you assume. Strain 1 is T1 by area divided by Young's modulus, and your strain 2 is, it is T2 by area whole divided by Young's modulus. You do the simplification. If you are doing it properly, on the bottom part it is 10^-4, on the top part it is 3×10^-4. It is unitless quantity because it is ratio. Next. Your next question is, you have two blocks. Lot of questions can be related to this thing. Which one? This chapter, Newton's laws of motion. And because tension is the internally developing restoring force, they can ask you a lot of questions on this. What is happening is, you are applying some force F on this block. This is massless pulley. M1, M2 are masses. You are applying a force of m2g/2 on this block of mass m1. Area of cross section of wire is, here you have wire connecting the blocks. Area of cross section is a. Young's modulus of this wire is y. Question is, find strain developed. Rope is light rope. If nothing is mentioned, consider light rope. Find strain developed in wire. That is your question. So try it for a minute, then I'll explain the solution. Pause the video clip, try it for a minute, then you continue the video. So trying is most important part here. You have to keep your efforts genuinely. Alright, now we will do the solution now. So drawing FBD, that will give you some tension T here. This is the tension T here, this is M2G. So if you write equations from FBD of M1, F minus T is equal to m1 into acceleration a, because you are applying force like this, it will move this way. And when top one goes to the left, this goes upwards. T minus m2g is equal to m2 into a. Now add these two, in place of f substitute m2 by g. So you are going to get a is equal to m2g by 2 times of m1 plus m2. What is that I am doing? I am adding the equations. Okay, so basic simplification you are supposed to do it. Okay, right. Next, second thing is substitute this back into any one of the equations and you will get your t as, okay, m2 plus 2m1 times m2 into g by m1 plus m2 times 2. This you are supposed to get it. Okay, simplification if you are not getting, okay, that means what is going wrong is your maths. Okay, how to simplify? Okay, that you have to learn from the maths only. That comes only through practice. Whenever you get stuck at the maths part, ask help from your friends or teachers where you are doing wrong. Okay, if you are at my place, you can ask me freely, then I will explain what is to be learnt. Okay, now you are asked what is the strain. So Young's modulus is stress tension by area by strain. Okay, stress by strain. From here your strain is T by A into Y. Substitute this T into this, you will get the answer. Okay, so your final answer is 2M1 plus M2 into M2 into G by 2 times of M1 plus M2 times A into Young's modulus. Okay, so this is how you are supposed to do this question. Okay, right. Now next we will see some very interesting question. Okay, so many times you will see questions related to breaking stress. What is this breaking stress business? You are supposed to know and understand in detail. So breaking stress in the sense, when stress becomes beyond the elastic limit, I told you in the stress strain curve very clearly, your material will reach the fracture point, and when material reaches fracture point, what will happen? Okay, your material will break. Okay, when material reaches fracture point, your material will break. So when material is breaking, okay, when material is breaking, what will happen is your material will, okay, break when you cross the elastic limit and reaches the breaking stress. Okay, so what is your question is, okay, we'll do some more questions, don't worry, but basic questions in this first lecture, that's all. Remaining separately, private links for my students, M2, M1, and then you have a hanging mass like this. Okay, now the two wires are made up of same material. Your breaking stress is given as, your breaking stress is, it is, its value is 8 into 10 power 8 Newton per meter square. Your area of cross section is 0.006 centimeter square. Okay, so unit I am not able to write it on the corner, but it is 0.006 centimeter square for upper wire. Okay, for lower wire, area of cross section of lower wire is 0.003 centimeter square. Okay, and your mass M1 is given as 10 kg, M2 is given as, okay, this is 10 kg, M2 is 20 kg. Okay, what is your question is, find maximum weight that can be put on hanger, that can be put on hanger. Okay, which will break if wire is released. Okay, try this question. First, pause the video clip, try this question, get the answer, then you look at the solution. Okay, that is the correct approach of doing things. Okay, so this part is 10, this part is 20. Now, an important thing that I want you to understand is, in questions like this, inequalities are involved. Okay, so when inequalities are involved, what will happen is you have to look at inequality on the top, inequality at the bottom, and then do the calculation. Okay, now because breaking stress is same for both the wires, okay, what will we do is we can calculate tension that is allowed on the top wire and bottom wire. Okay, so you will have M1 into G, and then some Mg will be there here. Okay, so some T will be there, and this part is indirectly T. So now if you are observing carefully, from Newton's laws of motion, if you take a BD of this span, bottom span, T is equal to Mg. Next, for the M1, if you take T1 is equal to T plus M1 into G, so that is indirectly M plus M1 into G. Similarly, if you are taking FPD of M2, T2 is T1 plus M2 into G, so T1 plus M2 into G, so that will give you M plus M1 plus M2 into G, like this. Okay, so I have calculated tensions. Okay, but what is tension means? It is your breaking stress into area. So, I mean, what is the restoring force that is developed? I am calculating. So, on the top wire, okay, let us say this is 2, this is 1. So, on 2, okay, your T2 value is supposed to be greater than, that means your restoring force should be greater than. For it to not to break, okay, it is stress into area, okay, because stress is force by area, okay, your tension is 8 into 10 power 8 into area is 0.006 into 10 power minus 4. Your T2 should be greater than or equal to 10 power 8 minus 4, that will give you 10 power 4, 10 power 4 into 0.006 means that will be 60, 8, 6 are 48. So, around 480 Newton should be your T2. So, your tension T2 should be greater than or equal to 480 Newton. And at the same time, on one, if you are taking T1 is greater than or equal to breaking stress of this wire is 8 into 10 power 8 into what is the value means? It is 0.003 into 10 power minus 4. So, you are going to get 240 Newton. So, that means your tension on bottom wire should be greater than 240. Tension on top wire should be greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. Okay, why am I putting greater? Okay, for it to not to break, it should be less. Restoring force should be less. Not greater than, okay, it should be less. Okay, so less than 480 and less than 240. Okay. So, whatever M value you are keeping, that should satisfy these both conditions. Both are to be satisfied. Okay. So, we need to give our answer such that both will be satisfied. Okay. Now, how is that I am going to give you think for a minute. Right. Now, observe very carefully. So, your T1 is supposed to be satisfied and T2 is also supposed to be satisfied. Now, because M1 is given as 10 kg, so on this, if you are keeping 10, Now, to satisfy this condition, okay, to satisfy T1 less than 240, okay, to satisfy this condition, what will happen is this value of M1 should be approximately how much means, okay, overall it is 24, no, so 14 kg is 14 plus 10, 240. Now, if you place the mass as 14 kg small m, your tension is exactly becoming 240. So, anything less than 14 kg is okay. Okay, next. Assuming 14, let us calculate T2. So, if you do so, okay, assuming 14, if I try to calculate, okay, this value, this is 14, this is 10, this is 20. So, 20 plus 10, 30, 30 plus 14, 44. Okay, so 44 into G value is 10. So, you are going to get T2 is equal to 440 Newton. So, if I keep, okay, if I keep this 14 kg, okay, my T2 value is less than 480, which is less than 480. So, that means, okay, what is the maximum value that I can keep is 14 kg. Both the conditions are supposed to be satisfied. Okay. So, I can keep a maximum value of 14 kg. If I keep 14, okay, anything slightly less than, okay, beyond 14, it will start breaking. Okay. So, this is how you are supposed to do this question. Okay. Right. Now, like this, you are supposed to calculate tension, and then in restoring force equal to tension by area, you have to substitute that value and do different questions. Okay, right? So that's all. Next, we'll continue further. Your next question is, it is related to conical pendulum. So your question is, you have a bob that is going in circular path like this, okay. Now, attached to this, there is a 1 kg mass and it is suspended to a cord of which is 2 meter long, and your area of cross section is, for this wire, your area of cross section is 0.05 centimeter square, and it is made to describe a circle of radius r equal to 50 centimeter, okay, in 4 seconds, okay, 1 revolution in 4 seconds, in 4 seconds 1 revolution. That means what is given? Indirectly, time period is given. Your Young's modulus of this is given as 5 × 10⁸ Newton per meter square. Okay, question is, find tension in cord. That is, you are supposed to find out extension of the cord. Okay, find extension of cord. Try this, then I will explain the solution. Alright, so now the answer to this question is, we are supposed to calculate the extension of cord. Now, once again, Young's modulus is what we have. So, your Young's modulus is stress by strain. So, strain is delta L by L. Okay, this part is L. Now, in this, we are supposed to calculate delta L. And one more thing is tension. Now, to calculate the tension, what is it we are supposed to do is, first, we have to use the circular motion idea. So, you have T this way and you have Mg this way. Now, for conical pendulum, if you watch my circular motion video, then you will get to know, in any circular motion, we will do the same thing. If this angle is theta, this will be theta. So, your T cos theta is equal to Mg. T cos theta part is equal to Mg. T sin theta is equal to Mv square by R. So, your T cos theta is Mg. T sin theta is equal to mv square by r. Now, we know opposite side, sin theta is opposite side by hypotenuse. This is centimeters, this is meters. So from here your sine theta is 50 centimeter by 2 meters is 200 centimeter. Centimeter centimeter will cancel off. You will get sine theta. Cos theta value also you can calculate. You substitute in this and you get t. T is squaring on both sides and you add it. T square sine square theta plus T square cos square theta is equal to m square g square plus m square v power 4 by r square. From here you get the value of t, substitute in this f value, substitute the value, simplify, get the answer. Okay, so if you are doing it correctly, you should get delta l is equal to 2.52 centimeter. Okay, now here this question I have picked up from the book, so that is why your numbers are not actually proper. But in the exam, if at all if a question comes, you will get some neat numbers wherein which you will get something like integer type 2 centimeter, something such kind of stuff, you will get it. You can simplify and then do the answer. Okay, right. Next, coming to your next part, your next question is like this. You have a steel rod or wire whose length is L equal to 1 meter like this, and your cross sectional area, your area here is 4 mm square, 4 millimeter square, and the two ends lie is clamped at two ends, clamped at two ends in the sense it is fixed like this here and without tension initially. Now what is happening is you have suspended a load. Now after suspension of load, what will happen is it bends like this. It is bending like this because of its mass m is 2.16 kg. Okay, it is suspended at the middle point. Okay, your Young's modulus of the steel, okay, same wire, it is bending after because of the suspension, it will bend like that. Your Young's modulus is 2 into 10 power 11 newton per meter square. Your g value is 10 meter per second square. What is your question is, okay, what would be the vertical depression? That means if I assume this to be your y, find the vertical depression y, find vertical depression y. Okay, so try this question for a minute, pause the video clip, try this question, then I will explain the answer. All right, so this question is basically picked from Irdow, and in this question, it is of slightly higher level idea. You will not be able to solve the question so easily. So I will help you out. Observe very carefully. This depression y will be small. We have to use binomial approximation and then do lot of stuff. So I will tell you. So this angle is 90 minus theta. This angle is theta. This is theta. This is 90 minus theta. This distance will be half meter, this distance will be half, okay, which is basically L by 2, okay, where L is 1 meter. Now here, T will be this way, your gravitation force mg will be this way. So your 2T sine of 90 minus, it is cos, okay, horizontal components will cancel off. So 2t cos of 90 minus theta will be equal to mg. Okay, now cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta, so 2t sin theta is equal to mg. Now because theta is very small, your sin theta is equivalent to tan theta, which is equal to L by 2 whole divided by y, which is equal to L by 2y. Okay, here obviously extension in these materials, it will be very small. So that will give you L by 2y, okay, opposite by adjacent. So now, sorry, you are taking theta is not this, no, this is 90 minus theta, sorry, it is y opposite by hypotenuse. For theta, y is your opposite side and adjacent side is l by 2, so that will give you 2yyl. Okay, now here your change in length is, okay, this hypotenuse length, okay, observe this, I am keeping it with help of red color, this total red color length minus top green color wire, so 2 times of, okay, under root, it is l by 2 whole square plus y square minus l, that is your change in length. Okay, now this delta l, first we will calculate. For this I will use binomial approximation. This will become l square by 4 plus y square whole power 1 by 2 minus l. Okay, now don't worry about this too much now. Okay, for mains and NEET, mostly this question will not be asked. This question, out of 30 questions in mains, or 25 questions, okay, according to the latest pattern, around 22 questions will be mediocre and 3 questions will be tough. Okay, so picking this question to do, it is a bad choice, but still if you are preparing of slightly higher level, it is good. For NEET people, I will say, just understand logic, that's all. Okay, don't worry what is this binomial approximation business and all. Okay, if you start thinking that way, you will get terrified. Okay, but it is easy only. Okay, because I am giving the detailed steps. Okay, so according to that logic, okay, I will even take L out of this. Okay, L by 2 we will take out. So if you simplify it further, if you take L by 2 common out, that will become L by 2 times 1 plus 2 times of L by 2 times 1 plus 2y square by L square. Okay, because it is actually 4y square. 1 plus x whole power n is 1 plus nx. Okay, so I will rearrange. Okay, you will get to have clarity. So 2 times of L by 2, if you take out, okay, this will become 1 plus 4y square by L square whole power 1 by 2, okay, minus L, 2, 2 will cancel off, this is in the form of 1 plus x whole power n, okay, so this is in the form of 1 plus x whole power n, when x is very much less than n, 1 plus x whole power n can be written as 1 plus nx, so that will give you L times 1 plus 2y square by L square, you will get minus L. So you are getting your change in length as, okay, so it is it is how much means, it is you are going to get it as, okay, L plus this will come, this will give you delta y, L is 2y square by L, this plus L minus L will cancel off. Okay, so that is your delta L. Okay, finally we have got change in length expression. Okay, now once you get this change in length expression, okay, now this change in length can also be written as delta L is equal to stress by strain, tension by area by, okay, Young's modulus is T by A whole divided by delta L by L. From here your delta L term I will rearrange, your delta L is, okay, it is T into L by A into Y. Okay, now substitute this back into this equation. Okay, so in place of delta L, we will substitute, no? So substitute it here. So now here we have this T, in place of T, 2T sin theta, we have mg, no? So T can be replaced with mg by 2 sin theta. So your delta L 2y square by L is equal to, okay, it is T is mg by 2 sin theta, this part is T, times L by A into Y. Okay, so that will give you 2y square by L is equal to mg L by 2 times, we have got sin theta as 2y by L, times this part is mg L by A into Y. Okay, so you simplify the values, substitute everything, you separate your small y, okay, this is Young's modulus, okay, this is your capital Y is Young's modulus, this is small y, okay. So from here you separate your small y and keep everything power 1 by 3 because you will get y cube term. So if you simplify, you are going to get around 1.5 centimeter, okay. Now this question, actually I am not supposed to do it in the mains lecture, okay, but in H.C. Verma this question is actually from I. Iredov, and Iredov is a book which is collection of Olympiad problems, okay. So that is for JE advanced part. Some high level questions will be there. In this much depth they will not ask in the exam for mains and NEET, okay. So this question is supposed to be from advanced lectures, but you have to understand that questions can be linked like this, okay. They can link with circular motion, they can link with other chapters as well, okay, right. So all those chapters accordingly you have to simplify and then do it, okay. They can ask torque, they can relate equilibrium, lot of other multi idea questions can be asked, okay. So if you are serious about your preparation, then it will not be a tough job for you guys, okay. Right, now your next question is, you have a metallic rod of length L, okay, mass this, okay, its length is L, radius of cross section is R. It is rotating about this axis with angular velocity omega, okay. Question is, this is a standard question, calculate tension as function of distance x, okay. From here to here, if this distance is x, calculate Tx is your first question, okay. Then calculate elongation of rod because of rotation, internally restoring force will develop because of the tension. So you are also supposed to calculate elongation of rod, okay. Assume density is sigma, density of material is sigma, Young's modulus is y, okay. Now try this question, then I will explain the answer, okay. Now this question directly you cannot do it, but you need to have knowledge in dynamics. Now to solve this question, first of all, okay, if you have watched dynamics video you will get it, but still even this is slightly higher level question, no issues. Now here what happens is, if you take a small elemental strip at a distance x dx, this small elemental strip will have mass dm, m mass will have length L, dm mass is having dx length. So because it is direct proportionality, more mass more length, cross multiply, m into dx is equal to dm into L. From here dm is m by L into dx, point number one. Next, because density is given, mass is volume times density. Here density is given as sigma. What is your volume is area of cross section into length, pi r square into L is m. Lastly, you substitute these two also, okay, in place of m. Now if you take tension, okay, here what happens is your tension will vary like this. It is T here, it is T plus DT, or you can write this thing, okay. There will be pulling because of left side as well as right side, okay. So now here with respect to distance, if you are doing, okay, along the length your tension will actually decrease, okay. At the end there are no molecules to pull, tension comes because of pulling, okay. So here what happens is your tension becomes zero at the end. So that is why your tension will actually keep decreasing. So that is why I have kept it as T minus DT. Now if this body is going in circular path, or for that matter, when anybody goes in circular path, what is our equation is, our net force towards center is equal to net force towards center, we write it as mr omega square. This is from circular motion. Okay, so we will write the equation from circular motion. Okay, now if you do so, what happens here is your dt, okay, your net force towards center is dt. Your dt is equal to dm into x into omega square. Okay, your dt is dm into x into omega square. Okay, now here integral of dt is equal to, okay, your integral of dt is equal to integral of dm into x into omega square. Okay, so now we have expressed your tension as a function of displacement. So dt is equal to dm into x into omega square is what you have. Okay, right? So your tension is integral of dt is equal to integral of dm into x into omega square. Now what is integral of dt means? It is t. So your t of x minus 0, upper limit minus lower limit, is equal to integral of from x equal to l to x, okay, your m by l into dx into x into omega square. Now this m, l, omega square, all are constant. So m omega square by l times x square by 2 upper limit l lower limit x, that is equal to your t of x. Okay, now your t of x from here you will substitute, you are going to get m omega square x square by 2l minus m omega square l square by 2l is what you are going to get from this expression. Okay, now you have got tension as a function of distance. Okay, so you are going to get this much value. Now in place of m, bring this and substitute into this, you will get the required answer. Then your extension, if it is asked, okay, your extension or elongation, if it is asked, okay, you integrate, okay, your small expression delta l is, okay, it is f into l by a into y is your expression. Now in this expression you do, this is your small extension dx you have, or some dl you have, that will give you integral of dl from al to y from x equal to 0 to x equal to l. In place of f you keep this tension distance and then you do all the required integration. If you simplify, you are going to get sigma omega square l cube by 3y. Okay, now this is also another advanced question, okay, mainly for MPC people. For BIPC people, end result you mug up, that is more than enough. Okay, right, next, your next question is, okay, you have a ring like this, and for this ring, okay, for this ring, you will have, this is d theta, this radius is r. Okay, what is that we are going to do is, for this ring we are going to calculate, okay, this d theta and all will not be given in the question. Okay, I will directly give the question. Its Young's modulus is y, area of cross section is a, your density is rho. Okay, rho is density, and then in within this plane your ring is rotated with angular velocity omega. Area of cross section is not given, density is given. Okay, what is your question is, find increase in radius because of rotation. Your question is this, find increase in radius because of rotation. That is your question. Okay, so this is what you are supposed to calculate. Okay, now try this, then I will explain the solution. Now for these kind of questions, I told you many times and I will keep telling, take a small strip like this, you zoom it. If you are zooming it, you will have tension T acting this way, tension T acting this way. You extend this, then you will have small angle d theta by 2, d theta by 2 on this side. This side it is 90, this side it is 90. This will become 90 minus d theta by 2. This will become 90 minus d theta by 2. So your centripetal force 2t cos of 90 minus d theta by 2 is equal to your small mass dm into r into omega square. Now m mass will have a length of 2 pi r. Your dm mass will have length of r d theta. Cross multiplying, you will get dm is equal to mr d theta by 2 pi r, where your limits are varying from 0 to pi. Cos 90 minus theta is sin theta, so that will give you sin d theta by 2. Your dm is mr d theta by 2 pi r times r omega square. R will cancel off. Sin d theta by 2 can be replaced because the angle is small. Sin theta is equivalent to theta. So that will give you mr omega square by 2 pi into d theta. Okay. So that will give you the tension d theta 2, 2 will cancel off. So you are going to get T as mr omega square by 2 pi. Okay. Now once you get this tension, okay, what is your Young's modulus? Is stress by strain. So that is T by A by, what is your strain means? Change in length. So that is 2 pi times R plus delta R minus 2 pi R by, original length is 2 pi R for this entire ring. Okay. So now you simplify. Okay. You simplify this. Your denominator is going to become T by A by delta R by R. Okay. Now your density is mass by volume. Volume is length into area of cross section is A. So from here M by A can be replaced. Bring it, you simplify everything and then you calculate your delta R value. If you are doing it correctly, you are going to get rho omega square R cube by Young's modulus. Okay. So like this you are supposed to calculate your Young's modulus value, okay, and increase in radius. Okay, so like this you will be calculating your basic questions. Okay, now here, okay, these basic ideas are more than enough and all the basic questions you can do on your own. And with this we'll stop this lecture. Okay, so most of these questions are of kind of advanced level. So those who are actually doing HC Verma, for them to be helpful, I am doing these questions, that's all. Okay, and in my advanced lecture you will have everything explained and all these techniques. Whenever you have this kind of object, how to take this small strip and all, everything will be discussed in detail. So this is only a quick this thing for those people who are doing HC Verma. Okay, right. So with this we'll stop today's class. Thank you.